Well, he's... Oh, really? Yeah. Well, we are going to find out more about our guest this morning. First off, he is known worldwide as a fashion czar of Asia. And for over 50 years, acclaimed Filipino designer Pitoy Moreno has been dressing up some of the world's most elegant women in formal Filipiniana. With his intricate beadwork and hand-painted fabrics, he embodies the Philippine fashion aesthetic, providing inspiration to designers. Next week, Metro Society pays tribute to the Filipino fashion icon and national artist via a tribute gala in celebration of his genius, artistry, and creativity. And we're very happy to be joined in the studio this morning by Metro Society Editor-in-Chief Raul Manzano and two of Pitoy Moreno's muses, socialite Conchitina Bernardo, consultant for the Pitoy Moreno Tribute Gala, and 1975 Miss Universe fourth runner-up Chiki Brosas, as well as Pitoy Moreno's best friend, designer Eddie Ocampo. Good morning to all of you, and thank you so much for joining us. It's wonderful to see, I'm sure you guys are all friends as well, but the four of you unified and really paying tribute to such a fashion czar of Asia and our national artist, Pitoy Moreno.
Yeah, we believe that it's time to, I have my mic now, thank you. We believe it's time to honor Pitoy. Mm-hmm. We feel that he is a national treasure, mm-hmm, and a national artist.
Well, I think many people feel the same way as well. You guys didn't fall short of doing any sort of tribute in the new issue of Metro Society.
Oh yes, we devoted the whole issue to Pitoy. The entire issue is on Pitoy Moreno.
Tell us about the perspectives that you guys.
Okay,
really
we did Pitoy in all his different angles. You know, as an international designer, as a couturier, as a foremost as a Filipino, mm-hmm, and we interviewed all these lovely people here, and they assisted us in putting the magazine together.
So we have different perspectives
of Pitoy,
seen through the eyes of
his
closest friends, yes, right? Well, I guess let's find out how we can really get to know the Pitoy Moreno through people who know him best. Ma'am, you know him for so many years now, I guess.
Well, a long time. I've known him for a very long time. Let's not go into the number of years.
Okay?
But it's been a long time. But it's been short in the sense that it's been very nice. He's, mm-hmm, been more than just a couturier. I've been more than just a model as far as he's concerned. He's treated me like somebody he loves, mm-hmm, and the feeling is mutual. He saw me through my wedding, my children's weddings, and he has refurbished a christening gown that all my grandchildren have been using. Pitoy is not just a couturier to me. Mm-hmm. He's a lifelong friend.
Well, that's very, very fortunate of you. I know, mm-hmm, there are a handful of people who can really call him a dear friend.
Yes, that's true.
What is he like? If there's something that really
special?
Not a lot of people, yes.
Oh my
about
gosh,
him.
Pitoy never forgets a birthday, never forgets an anniversary. Mm-hmm. He's famous for his buko pie. Okay, there's no buko pie like Pitoy's buko pie. Whenever you invite him, he brings it to a party. He's very thoughtful, mm-hmm, and more than that, he's very caring. Mm-hmm. My mother was ill for a very long time. My mother and he had a bond. I could probably say that my mother discovered Pitoy in more ways than one, because she was writing then for the old Manila Times, mm-hmm, and she was a society columnist, and she wrote extensively about him, and he never forgot that, no? And when she was ill, he would visit her, you know, show her love, mm-hmm, pray with her, and I keep that in my heart. You know, I keep that in my heart, because those are very special moments.
Well, I think this is the time when you're able to give some of that back and have other people get to know
Pitoy. Conchitina wrote
more.
A very special article, mm-hmm, in the magazine. It's called Pitoy, My Friend. And she goes through their whole lifetime relationship. So it's like very nice.
That's right, because a lot of people really just see, you know, from the third person perspective,
right,
someone who's very proud to be Filipino. Mm-hmm. But really, on his personal side, he acts very, he's a dear Filipino at heart with the way that he treats his friends. Well, I mean, there are a few women who are also very fortunate enough to be a muse of Pitoy Moreno's.
Yes.
Ms. Chiki, what was that like? I mean,
actually,
only the beauty queens and in a very select few.
Well, before I became a beauty queen, he actually had a group of ladies go to Europe to model. Mm-hmm. So we were together for like a month. And it was really lots of fun, you know, being with Pitoy. He would always be very cautious about, you know, how we present ourselves. Mm-hmm. He would always say, "Okay, smile, ladies." Mm-hmm. He'd be like our parang father, mm-hmm. you know. So he was very, very caring and very protective. And I remember when I joined the beauty pageant, and this was for the Miss Universe in El Salvador in Central America. Mm-hmm. He lent me a gown, and that gown really rated high. It was one of the reasons why I think I placed in the contest.
Yeah. Well, I mean, his intricate attention, his attention to
the attention to detail.
Is really quite beautiful. Yeah. I know we have some pieces I think we're going to see a little bit later on that are also going to be seen on the show. But of course, I want to ask one of his dear friends that has known
Eddie,
him
through
since you're 16,
well,
I
you
guess,
know,
or Eddie, right?
Yeah, I just came from the province to go to college, actually, when I, you know. Then one of the friends, Gilbert Perez, who was a professor, was my professor. And then he saw some of my sketches, and mm-hmm. they got so interested. And he brought me to Pitoy. And ever since that time, it was love at first sight, you know. He right away sensed my
talent.
My talent and you know, who doesn't want to meet Pitoy Moreno at that time, you know?
Eddie has accompanied him on over 40 trips abroad?
Yes.
40 fashion trips.
Wow, I mean, you guys have really spent a lot of time together, and that's surprising because I can't seem to stand
before
my best friend.
You know, actually, he basically made me, you know, he molded me into what I became, you know. Although I did not practice my craft in here, I practiced it in the States, you know. Mm-hmm. But he was responsible for everything I knew.
Now, when you see pieces that Pitoy has created, are there things or aspects about it? What aspects about it do you particularly say, that's Pitoy, my friend. I see my friend in
definitely,
those pieces.
Oh, definitely.
For example?
No matter how European he tries, you know, there is always a Filipino touch in his creation. That's one thing he never did, is to stray away from the Filipino.
He's foremost a Filipino.
Yes,
that's what he always tells everyone.
Well, there's definitely to be a lot to be proud of in the pieces that he creates. We have two of them here with us, and these are going to be found as well in the Metro Society party.
Yes, and it's going to be modeled by a professional model.
Oh, wonderful! Tell us about the two pieces, Raul, if you may.
I think Eddie would be the best to talk about it.
Well, these were for the fashion shows before. Can I mention the name of
Carol.
Okay, the black gown was modeled by Carol Masiwai, you know, and the other one was used by, well, a lot of them used it. It's Karen Agustin. Mm-hmm. So this has been around the world so many times, actually.
Well, I mean, you take the classic Filipiniana, and there's definitely a modern twist to it.
Yes.
I mean, the print,
draping.
The draping, and then the detail in the back of that black dress.
Conchitina just discovered some beautiful Mrs. Marcos gowns by Pitoy.
Well, will those be showcased as well?
Oh my
It was Eddie and I yesterday. We opened a trunk, and we found the most fabulous gowns.
Wow.
And it turns out that Mrs. Marcos had asked him to just keep it for her, you know. And these were gowns that were, Eddie, tell me, you were raving.
Because the first time they didn't show us those things. You know, so I told them finally, because they were bringing the wrong things. So I said, let me go up and take a look. And then we opened these trunks and I saw the most beautiful
gowns.
Is it just like hidden treasures
They are treasures.
It's
you know,
like opening the tomb of Tutankhamun, basically.
King Tut's alive.
I mean, as far as a couturier is concerned.
Will you be showing
the clothes
gowns?
Will be shown on exhibit. We have an exhibit before as you enter the ballroom.
Okay.
So some of the gowns of Pitoy from his old clients, and we hopefully from Mrs. Marcos, we will display them on mannequins before going into the show.
And some will also be modeled. modeled by
Samuel. Yes.
Okay.
The ones that you'll be seeing on display are gowns by Imelda Cojuangco. She's a fabulous icon, you know, and they're spectacular. And then Celia Diaz Laurel, he made beautiful ternos for her. And then there is a beautiful, beautiful gown of the Isobels, no? It's good. And Betsy Brias Westendorp, the artist. An old, old vintage Filipiniana that Pitoy made for her some years ago when she was still living here. Very beautiful.
Well, aside from paying tribute to Pitoy Moreno, I think that anyone who really visits the gala can also take a history lesson.
Yes, exactly.
History is told through the gowns, the pieces that he has created. Really, they're wonderful.
The gala also has a charity.
This is something that you cannot do anymore. It's a dead art, you know.
Well, we will relive it. We will relive it at the gala. The gala is when again, Raul?
It's on November 21.
That's all we can do.
Yes.
It's
November 21, Monday.
I will be there.
At the Edsa Shangri-La Hotel. We'd like to thank the Edsa Shangri-La for hosting us. And also, this is also a charity event. Part of the proceeds of the sponsors and some ticket sales are going to the Lopez Group Foundations.
Okay.
Which support community-based endeavors of the Lopezes.
Okay, well, I definitely will see you there. I know that Pitoy Moreno will be there as well. I know for those who may be curious, how is he doing health-wise, just before we...
Well, you know, time takes its toll on people. It does. And it's no secret that Pitoy is losing his memory. But then I have lost mine to some degree, and we all forget.
Some of us want to lose
Yes. He's managing well, he keeps himself well, and you're going to see, even in the pictures, that he's aware of what's going on. He's coping, you know, getting old is not easy. He's coping and he's doing quite well.
Well, it'll be a great party for him, a great celebration of his life and hopefully, his work and his art. And that's on the 21st.
On the 21st, yes.
Okay, we'll see you all there. Thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Now, up next, join us.